Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video tutorial, I'll show you how easy it is to create and edit worksheets in an Angular spreadsheet component. I'll demonstrate how to add, delete, rename, and hide sheets, as well as how to edit cells, save changes, and cancel edits in an Angular spreadsheet. First, I open my existing project, where I have installed the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular spreadsheet package, and all the necessary spreadsheet modules are configured in the app module file. I am opening the app component HTML file, where I added basic code for rendering the spreadsheet. In the app component file, I have assigned a data source object, order details, to the variable data. This data variable is assigned to the data source property. You can refer to my Angular spreadsheet getting started video to learn more about creating spreadsheets in an Angular application. I've shared the link in the card above and in the description below. Let me run this example and show you the initial output. You can see that the spreadsheet rendered with the specified JSON data. First, let me show you how to add a new sheet to the spreadsheet. To add an empty sheet next to the current sheet, you can click the Add Sheet button in the Sheet tab. Alternatively, you can right-click on the Sheet tab and select Insert from the context menu. This will insert a new sheet before the active sheet. Now, I will demonstrate how to insert a sheet using an external button click. First, I'll add a button tag and set its content to Insert Sheet. Then, I'll apply Syncfusion's button CSS styles by adding the class name eButton. And add an inline style with a margin 5 pixels to align the button. As mentioned earlier, I will be adding a new sheet using a button click, so add a click event and assign the callback method button click. Using this callback method, I will be calling the spreadsheet built-in methods. So, I create a spreadsheet component reference by adding the variable spreadsheet. In the app component TS file, I will define the button click method here. To access the spreadsheet instance, I will import the viewchild module from the Angular core package, where I pass the reference variable provided in the spreadsheet. And declare the variable spreadsheet object of type spreadsheet component. Notice here, the spreadsheet component will be automatically imported from an Angular spreadsheet package. Here, I will call the insertSheet built-in method using the spreadsheet instance. When the button is clicked, a new sheet will be inserted before the active sheet. Suppose I want to insert multiple sheets. Simply specify the start and end sheet indexes in the insertSheet method. Now, when the button is clicked, multiple sheets will be inserted before the active sheet. So far, I have bound the data to the spreadsheet using the data source property. However, I can also bind it using the insert sheet method and the created event. To do this, I will first comment out the sheets tag and add the created event and assign the callback method on create. This event will be triggered when the component is created. In the app component TS file, I defined the onCreate method. Now copy and paste the insertSheet method, and here I need to pass the sheet model. First, set the index to 1 and the name to order details. I set the ranges property and assign the order details data to the data source option. I will also include the columns property and assign widths to different columns. The index property is used to specify the index of the sheet that I will insert. The name property is used to specify the sheet name. The ranges property is used to specify the cell ranges. When the component is initially loaded, the order details sheet will be inserted next to the active sheet. When this sheet is clicked, it will display the order details data. Next, I will show you how to move the sheets to a specified position. In the button click callback method, call the MoveSheet built-in method using the spreadsheet instance, and I need to pass two parameters here. First parameter is a target index where the sheet needs to be moved. Second one is index of the sheets to be moved. I set target index as 0 and index of the sheet order details. To prevent creating multiple sheets on button click, comment out the insert sheet method. To change the button content, I open the app component HTML file and set the button content to move sheet. Check now, the spreadsheet renders with two sheets. The index of order details sheet is 1. When I click the button, it will move to index 0. Next, I will show you how to delete the sheet. Right-click on the sheet tab and click Delete option from the context menu. I can also delete a sheet using the built-in spreadsheet method. In the button click method, call the delete method using the spreadsheet instance and comment out other methods. Let me change button content in the app component HTML file. I set the content to delete sheet. Check now, when I click the button, the active sheet is deleted. Next, I will show you how to create a duplicate or a copy of an active sheet. In the callback method, call the duplicate sheet method using the spreadsheet instance. Then I must re-render the spreadsheet using refresh method. To change the button content, I open the app component HTML file and set the button content to duplicate sheet. Check now, when I click the button, the active sheet is deleted. And the sheet orders details is duplicated. To rename a sheet, right-click on the sheet tab and click Rename option from the context menu. Now, I will show you how to hide the sheets to prevent unauthorized or accidental changes. Since I am going to continue adding worksheets using the sheets tag, I uncomment it. To specify the sheet visibility, include another sheet and set the state property to hidden. I open the app component TS file and comment out the insert sheet method inside the onCreate method, as the data source has already been passed through the sheets tag. Currently, the newly added sheet 1 is not visible, but you can make it visible by selecting it from the list All Sheets menu. When I change the state to very hidden, the sheet 1 is not visible in list All Sheets menu. Next, I will show you how to edit cells in spreadsheet. You can edit a cell either by double-clicking it or pressing the F2 key. You can also edit cells using the built-in spreadsheet method. Inside the button click callback method, call the start edit method. Comment out other methods. Let me change button content in the app component HTML file. I set the content to start edit. Check now, when I click the button, the spreadsheet cell changes to edit mode. To save the cell, click Enter or Tab keys. Another option is by using the endEdit method. In the button click callback method, call the endEdit method using the spreadsheet instance. Comment out other method. To change the button content, I open the app component HTML file and set the button content to save. See now, I can edit the cell and click the button to save. To discard editing, simply edit a cell and press the escape key. Another option is by using the close edit method. In the button click callback method, call the close edit method using the spreadsheet instance. Comment out other method. Let me change button content in the app component HTML file I set the content to discard. See now, I can edit the cell and click the button to discard. Finally, I'll show you how to prevent editing in the column E using the cell edit event. I add the cell edit event and assign the callback method on edit. I open the app component TS file and define the onEdit callback method here. I add an if condition to check the column is E and set the cancel option to true to prevent editing. Check now, I am unable to edit the cells in column E. In this video, I have shown you how to add, delete, rename, and hide sheets. I also showed you how to edit and save cells and cancel editing in an Angular spreadsheet. You can download this working example from the GitHub link given in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, giving you a free license key to use our Angular products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.